Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Tanuja H., consultant obstetrician and gynecologist at Cloud9 Jayanagar. Prenatal screening tests are done to identify whether your baby is more or less likely to have any genetic disorder. This could be in the form of ultrasound or blood test. Screening is required to basically know the probability or the chances of your baby having a disorder. But screening is not diagnostic. So if the screening tests are doubtful, then you need to go in for a diagnostic test. All pregnant women should be offered the screening test. With increasing age, there is increased chances of chromosomal abnormality. The prenatal screening tests are offered both in the first and second trimester. In the first trimester, we do what is called as nuchal translucency scan, wherein we check for the measurement of the thickness of the nape of the neck in a particular position of the baby. And the blood test is the double marker test. This is more accurate or more specific. In the second trimester, we do what is called as quadruple marker or the triple marker screening test. There is also a test called prenatal cell-free DNA screening, wherein we take the fetal DNA segregated from the maternal blood and screen for the genetic disorders from this sample. This is almost 99% accurate. What do we do with the test results? If it comes as a normal or low risk, there's nothing else to be done. It's quite normal. That means your baby is normal enough. What you need to do next is the TFA scan at around 18 to 20 weeks, which is to see the structural anomalies. If it comes positive or high risk, then is where you need a diagnostic test. What is called as amniocentesis or chorionic villus sampling. These two are invasive testing. It's not practical enough to have the diagnostic test for every female in the pregnancy. So we do screening tests and then take a decision of whether an invasive testing is required or not.